you never want to hear the term, the statement, you have a brain tumor. But some of these are absolutely life-threatening. And so how are we going to cure these? And that's, you know, the main question.
No, that's right. And to do that, we really need a better understanding of how cancer cells behave. And that's what I study. But just to take a step back, what is cancer? It's really a conspiracy against your own body. Let me tell you the example of a regular scenario of a normal cell doing something, like your skin cells, let's say. And your skin cells will be dividing. You know, you get a cut, they divide, and things like that. Now, when you have sunlight hitting skin for too long, you can have the normal response, which is for that cell to die. And you see that here. But sometimes the cell doesn't die. And what happens then is that it can basically aggregate something called mutations or changes in their genetic code. And over time, what can happen is that they basically get deregulated. They're not listening to your body anymore. They're growing out of control. I study a group of cells called cancer stem cells, and they remind me a lot like of zombies. And I'll tell you why I think that.
Now, when you say stem cells, when people talk about stem cells or stem cell therapy, people often talk about embryos or fetal tissue or things like that. Are you talking about the same thing?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. I get this a lot. And basically, I'm not talking about embryonic stem cells or babies or fetal stem cells. What I'm talking about is a really ferocious population of a cancer mass. There are these certain cells, and I'll show you right here, that exist with the other cells you see in the middle. And now, regular therapies for cancers are quite good for these other cells that are lining, that are surrounding this cancer stem cell. But what happens is you get rid of the regular cells, but the cancer stem cell still remains. And that can proliferate over time, and then you get a tumor regrowth or recurrence again. So on the other hand, if you were to target the cancer stem cells, then what happens is, because it communicates with the other cells and it can cause the tumors to come back, you can actually cause tumor regression. So what I do in the laboratory, in collaboration with people like Dr. Leuthardt and others in the department, is we take out brain tumors, when appropriate, of course, and then what I do is I take those cells and I grow them in a dish. And I grow them in a dish for two purposes. One is to study them in a dish, and the other is to make tumors, kind of like the human scenario in a mouse. And we can use these cells to look at activities like cell growth or proliferation. And I'll give you an example here where you can use these fancy colorful dyes and treat these cells with different reagents to see what will affect their cell growth.
So you essentially get a virtual chance to treat these tumors in a number of different ways, and that really builds the foundation for future therapies.
No, that's right. So this is from human brain tissue, so it's not some model of it. This is from actual patients, so I believe that's right. It recapitulates much better what's happening in a human patient. And we can go one step further, like I just said. We can take these cells and put them into mice, and you can get these tumors as shown here on the left. And then you can use these mice to test various therapies and other manipulations to see if you can make this tumor go away.